Hey everybody, and I know I say this a lot, but welcome to a weird Let's Look At, and this is a particularly weird one, because this is Super Sanctum TD, and you know, that doesn't stand for Toronto Dominion Bank, that stands for Tower Defense, as you might expect, because Sanctum is a, well, Super Sanctum TD is a spin-off of Sanctum, which is a series of first-person shooter slash tower defense hybrids. Now, the reason this is a weird Let's Look At is because, A, this is a spin-off, but I have not played the original game, although I will be covering Sanctum 2 when it comes out next week. And B, this is a pre-order bonus that is also available as a standalone game on Steam. So if you pre-order Sanctum 2, you get access to this kind of weird 16-bit stylized pure tower defense game. And I think that's super fucking cool. Like, that's one of the neatest pre-order bonuses I've ever seen. Even though I've never played the original Sanctum, I was like, you know, I think I'd want to cover this just because it's such an interesting kind of pre-order bonus. Like, a standalone, unique, original game as a pre-order bonus? It's small, sure, but it's kind of cool. I kind of liken it to maybe, you know, if Far Cry 3 came out and Blood Dragon had just been developed as, like, a pre-order bonus. That's super cool. Anyway, we're going to play this. It's Tower Defense. You're going to figure out what's going on pretty quickly. But there's a lot of things I like about this game. And a lot of things that, you know, make it kind of appealing. One of them is that it's only $3, I believe. It might be $4 on Steam if you want to buy it standalone. And I'm not usually the biggest fan of tower defense, but I like this enough, shall we say, to spoil my opinions for later. So we can select our towers. This represents about, you know, what I've unlocked in an hour and a half of play. Only meant to play like half an hour, but then kind of got sucked into it. So these are all fairly standard. Gatling gun is just like our standard machine gun turret. Lightning is an area of effect that also slows a little bit. Mortar is artillery. Mine deployer is a unique one. I'm going to be using Gatling gun, mortar, and mine deployer. Basically, this just throws out mines that will eventually hit other enemies. Kairos is our slow, anti-air is our, you know, anti-air. We also have these spells that we can use, and almost like a warlock master of the arcane style. These are going to be spells that have usually like an area of effect buff or an area of effect damage effect that have cooldowns and that we can use kind of real time as things go. So I'm just going to be taking a mine, which is basically like a trap that we can set, as well as the bomb, which is just a big firestorm that comes from the sky, basically, that we can target. So the kind of unique thing about Super Sanctum TD from a tower defense standpoint is this is, to the best of my knowledge, this is the only tower defense game I've ever played that has kind of 16-bit styling, which is kind of unique. And, you know, it looks better than Super Nintendo games, I would say, but it's got kind of its own unique style as well, which is kind of interesting. I'm not trying to fight people and say, like, oh, this looks better than Super Metroid or something like that. There's other factors that go into it, of course. And the other thing that's kind of unique is not only do we build our own maze, you can see me putting down blocks here that kind of force them to go through the center, but we actually build our turrets on the maze. So, I mean, Field Runner sort of does this, as your turrets are the maze, but it adds an interesting level of, maybe not depth, but kind of an interesting level of originality in that you could spend a lot of money organizing your maze, and then, like, not very much money on turrets, or you could do, you know, only place blocks where you want your turrets to be. Anyway, I'm not good enough at tower defense to get into that for the most part. The other thing I really love about this is that it has a really, really kind of unique and intuitive interface. Maybe not unique, but intuitive at least. So if I click and drag a turret out here, I can easily see what its area of effect is and what its active range is when it comes to hitting enemies. So I really like that because it makes it really easy to tell when you should and should not place turrets. So let's start building first here. You can see the number of waves left and the number of dollars that I have. You can also see the experience that I have, and that will be used to unlock extra slots that we can use later in the game. So the first thing I want to do is put down some artillery, and I think I'm going to put it down right here because that gives it a huge kind of valid active range. And then I'm going to put down a Gatling gun turret, like right... I think I want to put it down in the middle of those spots, like so. And that means I can probably sell this one. Yes, okay. Let me think about this for a second. I also want to use a mine layer, and maybe I want to put this mine layer on this one right here. So what this does is, again, it shoots out mines. The problem is, if I click on it, well, okay, you can see the range now, but... It'll only have good mines in kind of this half area, this 50% of its range, and the other 50% are just going to land kind of harmlessly over here. So you got to weigh that, obviously, when you're creating it. Now we have 70 left. I think we should put down another mortar turret. Here seems like a good place, and we don't quite have enough. I think maybe if I sell this turret, I can put down, yeah, another Gatling gun here just for any enemies that get past. So we're going to start here, and I click go. And another thing I really like about this, well, before we talk about that, let's talk about this kind of Gears of War, like, meter that we have here, where when we cast a spell, if we hit it at the green meter time, it will actually give us an extra damage bonus. Now, here's the interesting thing. Is this going to be enough to kill these guys? Yes, it is. Okay, so that bodes well. I haven't really demonstrated that Gears of War style thing yet, but it has kind of like that Spy Party style, right? Where if you hit the meter at the right point, then you get a little bit of a buff. In this case, not to our animation, but to our actual strength. So, you know, we can... If we chose to, we could speed things up here. We could also buy turrets in the middle of the wave. It's not like it's discreetly divided into build phase and active time phase. And we've really got to pay attention here because, you know, you want to make sure that you're not accidentally letting any enemies through when you could be killing them by way of your special abilities. That was a total accident that I hit it perfectly there. But, you know, it seems like my setup's working pretty well so far, so we can just let this go. Maybe we'll click a fast-forward arrow, and this will make it go quickly. And that's another thing I like about this game is that it moves really quickly. I think a lot of tower defense games have a tendency to take themselves a little bit too seriously, which is really annoying when you're like, okay, I get that you want to be strategic, and maybe you are, but at the same time, I don't care. I just want to, you know, finish the wave, basically, especially in the early waves. But this has a very good fast-forward system. So now, you know, we've got $61. You played a tower defense game before. We have to balance, what do we want to do here? Do we want to upgrade our turrets, which is usually valuable, or do you want to buy more turrets, which is also valuable? I think, you know, $61, we can't upgrade our mortars. Those are way too expensive. We could upgrade our mine layer. So why don't we do that? That'll be interesting. I think it just causes it to fire faster. And then we'll go again. We could also build more blocks if we wanted to. But I'm going to focus mostly on just putting the mines down here. So in terms of tower defense games, there's a couple of things I really like about this. And, you know, I've mentioned a few of them. But what I also like is that you kind of have to constantly be paying attention. Because you really want to make sure you're maximizing your use of your active spells. Otherwise, again, you're just kind of, you're wasting your efforts, basically. So I've made a terrible mistake here, and enemies are starting to get through. The only thing I will say in terms of, like, a discrete building phase is that you can't actually build blocks during the secondary, like, active phase in the game. So you really have to have the infrastructure set up, and I'm getting my ass kicked here as you see these enemies are getting through here. No, don't ever let anyone tell you I'm good at tower defense games, because I am absolutely not. But, you know, every time an enemy gets through, they do a certain amount of damage to our core here. If the core dies, again, you play tower defense games. You're probably pretty familiar with how this works at this point. Oh, we got him barely! And I'm gonna make sure that I am constantly putting down these active spells whenever I possibly can. And maybe we can get lucky here and kill him. Okay, we actually then accidentally got a perfect there. And that, it happens to me more often than you'd expect that I accidentally succeed. This wave has not gone well. We're going to end up letting, you know, probably 25% of our total health fall away, which is not good. And this guy just keeps yelling at us because we suck. That's fair, though. Now let's build some better defenses. We got a lot more money there. And clearly our defenses here are not really getting the job done. We probably should have done something else as opposed to just upgrading our mine layer there. So I think a good idea might be to build some more artillery, maybe on this part right here, which has a pretty good active area. What about this part right here, too? Yeah, that seems pretty solid. I really like artillery in this game. And maybe we can put down another Gatling section here, just to make it a little easier. And I want to build one more block as well, maybe... Let me think about where this would be good. Maybe here, and I'll put a mine layer on that once we get a little bit more money. So I usually do play this game at full speed, and it's worked out okay for me so far, but as you can probably tell, I'm not super good at this. In terms of tower defense games, I've talked a lot about how I enjoy this one, but, you know, is this worth a purchase? That's all going to come down to how you feel about tower defense. I mostly wanted to cover this because it's kind of a strange curiosity as a standalone game that is also a pre-order bonus. Again, I have no idea if this was originally developed to be a standalone game that was going to see release, or if it's just kind of something that they decided to do as a show of goodwill towards fans. But either way, this really encourages me to actually pre-order Sanctum 2. I mean, this is hypothetical because I actually do have a press build already, but if I was a consumer, it would definitely encourage me to be like, oh, you know, they really are making an effort. They're not just saying, you know, get a coupon for $5 off some of our other games, or, you know, if you pre-order it, you get a 10% bonus. They're saying, if you pre-order it, you get this totally unique product. And you know what? Even if you don't want to pre-order it, you can also play this standalone product that we probably worked fairly hard on as well. That's super cool. Again, I don't think I made the analogy very well at the start, but it's kind of like if Blood Dragon was developed alongside Far Cry 3. Maybe it was, but then they just decided, you know what? We're gonna make the bonus if you pre-order Far Cry 3, you get Blood Dragon. It's kind of akin to that, but on a much smaller indie scale and probably more feasible indie scale as well. I don't know. I find the idea super cool. I hope I'm not gushing too much. Now, we are gonna put our. We should have put a mine layer here earlier, and let's try upgrading some more turrets because this worked out fairly well for us. The fucking Gatling gun turrets cost so much to upgrade. Do we have any more blocks? We do not. So again, we'll put down something else maybe here, and we'll put another artillery turret there when we get enough money. I think we're going to succeed on this one, but stranger things have happened than me losing in a tower defense game on camera. That's something that kind of has a tendency to happen all the time. So hopefully that mine layer works out well for us. Every time I say the mine layer, I feel like I'm saying like the Kingslayer from The Witcher or something like that. And by the way, this is very shallow. This level, I should say, is very shallow. because there was not, there was kind of like a superficial choice in how we wanted to design the maze. In actuality, in the later levels, we'll be able to design our maze with a lot more freedom, and it'll have a lot more impact on our success. So we'll probably see one more level in that, but I doubt that we will be doing like a super long video here. Mostly because, you know, when it comes to tower defense games, and no offense meant to tower defense developers, kind of what you see is what you get, and I feel like those are games where... you know, you either you like it or you don't, and me saying this is good or bad is not going to make a huge impact on whether you're interested, unless you're a very discerning tower defense player, which I don't know if those exist, but if they do, that's cool too, I suppose. So again, we're just letting kind of the enemies pour in here. We've got a nice setup. Those mines, unfortunately, they do disappear at the end of each round, which is unfortunate because it would make things a lot easier, probably. Let's upgrade this dude. He's one of my favorite artillery, and we'll get him to... 150, so he should be able to fire more often or do more damage. Again, I'm not 100% sure how it works, but it doesn't really matter, I think, unless you're playing on a much more or much less superficial level than I am. So let's crank this up again. Kind of just want to get to the eighth wave. It's a little bit generic in the sense that there's not really any I haven't encountered any boss mobs so far that have essentially, you know, made things super difficult. There have been some larger ones, but it's not like, oh shit, here comes, you know, Mrs. Sanctum or something like that. I don't know if that would even make sense. Again, I know nothing essentially about Sanctum, and I haven't even touched the second one yet, nor did I touch the first one. But I will! And especially, I'm more excited about covering the second one, just because of this kind of super weird style of bonus, which is... Again, I don't know if it's unprecedented, but it's unique to me, and that's pretty cool. So we are on wave 5 of 8. The difficulty ramps up, as it often does in games like this, pretty quickly. Not in terms of the levels necessarily, although the newest level that I'm playing is super tough. But in terms of the waves, you know, they get more crazy every single time. And also, you know, kind of this persistent experience system is nice because this allows us to unlock new towers. Maybe we get stuck at a level and fail it 4 times in a row. Well, maybe you unlock a new tower that helps you out. During that time as well. So we didn't even really come close to dying there, so I think another good course of action might be to upgrade this, and maybe we could toss down another Gatling gun turret just to help us out, or maybe even another mine layer, assuming this... it doesn't really have that good area of effect there. So let's put down another Gatling gun here, and we'll keep things going. Now the important thing is, you know, I have been gushing about the game a little bit, but keep in mind this is just your standard tower defense game. It's tower defense done well. I don't even know if it's tower defense done that uniquely, but there's nothing I have negative to say about this game, except for the fact that if you don't like tower defense games, it's very unlikely that you're going to like this. You know, it's a love it or hate it genre. But, you know, there's been a lot of tower defense games like Cube Men 2 that I've played recently and been like, you know, even as a tower defense fan, I find it hard to believe that a lot of people would be super into this. But this, it does absolutely nothing crazy wrong, which is important, I guess. It does everything that it needs to do. Sure, maybe it looks a little bit like an iOS game or something, but I actually think the visual style works pretty well. And yeah, just like, so I'm glowing a little bit, but you know, maybe it deserves it. Sometimes the games that I talk well about do indeed deserve the praise that they're receiving. Sometimes the games that I talk shit about might not deserve that kind of negative experience, but whatever. I'm looking at you, Xenoclash 2. Except the comments for Xenoclash 2, anyway. I still think that game's actually really bad. But, you know, again, let's not drag that whole mess over here. So I'm just going to continue upgrading our turrets here. The ones that I have not upgraded yet, anyway. And maybe we can throw down another mine layer. Whatever. Let's just throw down another Gatling gun here. And then go. So this is going to be wave 7. You know, we're playing a tower defense game. Wave 8 is likely going to be a cut above with respect to difficulty. I haven't really seen all that much variety in enemy types so far, but it's been pretty standard. You know, you've got your really fast, low HP enemies. You have your slower, tankier enemies. And then you have kind of standard mobs that populate the game to a much wider degree. And, you know, I don't know if this is a problem with my strategy or with tower defense games in general, but I always find that wave 1 tends to be super hard, and, like, wave ultimate, the final wave, tends to be super difficult. And then after that, you know, the ones in the interim are not so bad, so... I don't know, it's almost like playing a Judas run in the Binding of Isaac or something like that. Things start hard, and, you know, because it's Isaac, they always finish difficult as well, but, I don't know. I haven't run into too much trouble in the, like, rounds 2 to 8 so far. Enemies are starting to break through a little bit, but I think I might yet get another perfect here. And assuming I do, I'll be pleased about that. We should probably keep throwing these mines down here. We eventually do develop more spells and skills. I'm probably just going to continue calling them spells. Those are totally accidental perfects, by the way, but I'm glad that it's working. So on our final wave, we have a ton of cash. We should invest more in some crowd control, I would guess. These area of effects are nice. I haven't even mentioned this, but you know, if you click on a turret, you can adjust its aim mode. Mine layers you can't, because that would be cheap, I guess. But on a Gatling gun, you could like shoot for strongest, weakest, first, or last, or just by default. I just use default AI, but it's really nice that that exists, because that's a sore spot for me in tower defense games sometimes, is being like, oh, my AI is just really stupid about who it targets. So I'm just going to put down a number of extra artillery here, and I think this should really help us deal with a lot of the enemies. Artillery is like my overarching strategy. For better or for worse, and adding down another four of these should really help things out. But I think, you know, that isn't that the innate balance? Oh, there's a big bad right there. Isn't this the innate balance in, like, tower defense games where it's like, I shouldn't put the mine there, that was really stupid, actually. Where it's like, upgrading a turret is slightly better than buying a second of the same kind? Well, I don't really subscribe to that, as unfortunate as that might be. I think we're gonna have no problems here. This big guy's gonna go down pretty easily, especially if we get a perfect here, which we did. He's gonna walk into a number of mines, and this should be the end of this level. If he gets to the end, I'm not sure if we lose, or if he just takes off a bunch of health. I could see it easily going either way. Yup, there we go, he's dead. So we got victory. That's probably a 2-star, because I actually did take some damage there. So, you know, when we get this interface at the end, there's not much of a kind of completion screen. And it unlocks a new area for us, which we'd already been to, so that was kind of unnecessary. So let's check out this level, and I'll do a quick playthrough here. I'll probably lose, but it'll explain, and you can click here and see what kind of enemies we're going to get, but I'll explain the less superficial elements of the game when it comes to designing a maze. So here you have a level which is more of a sandbox than a linear level, and it's important for you to decide, okay, how do we want to do this so that we're going to send enemies through the most space possible? And what I'm thinking is you want to do something like this. So I'm going to send enemies through here, and then once they get down here, I'm going to kind of direct them over here. But obviously this changes their pathing by default, so you want to kind of, you know, set it up like this, maybe. Okay, so that's, we spent a lot of money making this kind of path happen here. But after this, then I want to route them, like, just put one here, and yeah, route them down here. And then after they come through here, I want to send them over. Okay, well, you know, we've got a problem here. We want to send them this way, and then down through here. So this is going to be a nice little maze for us, I hope. But we're going to really focus on this kind of starting area here, so that we can hopefully do a lot of damage to these enemies. I've never beaten this mission. I should say that as we get started here. I've had a lot of problems with it, and I hope that this is going to be one where we end up fixing it. So this seems almost to me like one where Gatling guns from the start seems like a really smart idea. And we might want to upgrade one of these even. No, we can't actually. Because, you know, we're going to have a lot of enemies coming through here. And that means that artillery is probably going to be useful as well. But I don't really know where the right place to put them is. Maybe here. And that's going to be all we've got here, so let's give this a try. I usually get totally butt-fucked on this mission, but, you know, I do have my spells as well, so hopefully this will... Oh, yeah, not a good start so far, I would say. But we'll try to do some crowd control on these enemies as they come through, and hopefully this will allow us to not get as beaten as I expect that we will be. But, you know, again, if we're not going to lose on this first wave in all likelihood. You know what I think the problem is? I think we could easily direct enemies closer to these Gatling guns turrets so they could hit them on the way back. I realize the core is taking damage, my friend. And I realize it's not going superbly for us here. Let's put a mine down here and drop this there. All right, that killed at least two of them. We might actually lose on the first wave here. Well, maybe not, but it's not going to be good. So I want to kind of direct enemies a little bit more towards the other side. The other problem is I didn't kill enough turrets, so I'm not going to get... I didn't kill enough enemies, so I'm not going to get too much in the way of extra help here. But this is not an easy tower defense game in the time that I've spent with it so far at all. So we have enough money for one more artillery turret. You know, that's not a horrible place for it, I think. This might be better, though. Sure. Well, let's get it started. Again, we didn't earn a lot of money. That's why I can't really afford to upgrade myself too well. So I'm just going to put some mines down here, and we'll keep firing these, please. Oh, God. Yes, we managed to get them. Okay, so maybe this has made a difference, because now the artillery turret will turn and fire on those guys as they leave. It's going better, at least. Well, not necessarily, but better. So with more money, why don't we put a... You know what? This is actually a perfect location for a mine shooter. And if we upgrade that, we should be able to make some really good stuff happen. And the artillery is also shooting the other enemies as it comes through, like this artillery down here. So I don't know if this is working out well or terribly, but we certainly haven't allowed as much damage through as we did last time, which is very beneficial, and we actually earned a lot more money. Okay, so let's think about this for a second. We have a decent setup, but not a good setup. And, you know, this can emphasize the time that they're there a little bit longer, maybe. Where are we? Where is another area where it would be good to... I think we should focus a little bit here, because this is where a lot of our enemies are coming in and kind of kicking my ass. And we can also hit both directions from here, which is important. So now we're out of money again. Let's try it again. Maybe this is exactly the setup I've always needed. And we'll continue putting mines, likely in a better location than I have in the past. Because that has been a historical sore spot for me so far. But again, you're kind of seeing my point that I mentioned earlier, which is like... I oftentimes feel like the game is just too easy in the interim stages, but in the first opening stages, it's really difficult. Now I've got a problem because enemies are pathing around the mines, but I can probably put a block down like here and push them into it, hopefully anyway. Yes, thank you, artillery turrets, for saving my life a little bit there. And this is going much better here. Again, it might be a personal problem with my like inability. We actually let a fast one through there. My inability to play tower defense games properly, or you know, perfectly strategically. But who knows, man? This is a hard level. I mean, I've somehow rendered this mine layer that I thought was actually in a great position almost totally useless, which is unfortunate. Oh, this one's not going to get through because I'm going to kill him just before he tries. I think actually the fast ones are the ones I should be focusing on, which means we should probably put some Gatling gun turrets down here towards the end. But it's going okay so far. We're at like half health, we're not halfway through, but it's scaling better for us. And again, remember, I can't put blocks here, so maybe we should just, yeah, put a Gatling gun down there to allow the artillery to clean up the mess. Should definitely drop one there, at least stop him a little bit. I don't know if there's different values to enemies' health, by the way, like I don't know if... If a strong enemy gets to the end, does that do more damage to the core? It doesn't seem so, but it might be. So again, you can see my mine layer kind of fucking up here. So I want to direct enemies into this kind of middle part. And this should be enough to make that happen. Alright, $104. How are we going to make this work? Artillery here is not great. So I'm going to do it, but I'm going to sell it. But artillery here might be awesome. It's not quite there. We can sell this one. Maybe artillery here would be awesome. So I just want to make sure it's hitting people at like both of these opportunities. So this seems pretty good. And why don't we put another one of these down here? And I don't know. At this point, I feel like I'm just kind of spamming Gatling guns. But that might not be the worst thing in the world to be spamming at this point. So let's try it again. I realize, you know, that it's probably getting a little stale at this point in gameplay. But yeah, it's tower defense. That's how it goes. You know, I'm not just going to do one level just in case things get, you know, vastly different or it totally fucks up afterwards. This is not going well. This is not going well thanks to those enormous dudes. But that actually did a ton of damage. And, you know, there is a Plants vs. Zombies kind of style. Click on the chest and you'll get more power-ups as well. Or more money, I guess, in this case. But it's not that important to pay attention to, I think. Maybe it makes a huge difference and that's why I'm not doing so hot right now. This could be a problem here. Actually, that was a really good mine. And a really good explosion as well. So put this mine down here. You want to try to get some crowd control going with the mines, obviously, but that's not always going to be possible. This big guy's definitely going to get through the end, and that's an issue. Ooh, he did way more damage, so I guess that answers that question. And we may end up losing this one again. But I have to stress that unlike most of my videos where I play much worse when I'm on camera, this one has actually gone substantially better for me than you would expect, maybe. All right, now here's the thing. Can we kill this guy? I think the mine will get him. Even if we don't manage to. And we've really just got to not take damage for the rest of the game. Which is, as you might expect, easier said than done. So let's crank up what's been really beneficial for us. I feel like this artillery is one that deserves an upgrade. And that is all we're going to get. So let's start here. Again, can't stress enough how valuable I feel it is to have a really quick-paced tower defense game. Because, you know, a game like Gratuitous Tank Battles... that's where that one kind of lost me. It had a nice strategic depth to it, but at the same time, it was too slow. I just couldn't get into it because, you know, I wasn't psyched about taking 20 minutes to play a single tower defense level. Whereas on this, you know, it's probably at this point I'm eating my words, cause it's probably like 12 minutes or something, but hopefully you get what I'm saying there. Oh, so I just literally threw the mine down right on top of that guy, but we're still, we're up against it here in a bad way. Not in a sweet-ass R. Kelly club grinding style way. And hopefully my artillery is strong enough to... Oh, okay, we're probably going to lose, like, right now, maybe? I probably should have changed the aim mode on that artillery turret, and that might have changed things. But let's just continue. You know, that level's been fairly difficult for me so far. But this is Sanctum or Super Sanctum TD. I think it's super interesting that it exists. It's not the best tower defense game I've ever played, but it is $4, and the visual style is really cool. So you can check this out either by picking it up on Steam for, again, $3 or $4, and there will be a link to the store page if you want to do that, or you can get it for free by pre-ordering Sanctum 2. So if you're a fan of the original and you have faith in the sequel, maybe that is the best avenue for you to obtain this. I think Sanctum 2 is $15. But in any case, as always, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.